welcome to this tutorial. In this video, we'll be creating an audio player with Elementor on your WordPress website. So, first of all, you will need a Jet Elements plugin to create this type of audio player. You can get Jet Elements if you follow the link in the description under this video. And here you can see the examples of the audio player modules that you can create with this plugin. This audio player can play files from your media library or from the external links. It became possible to create an audio player, a fully designed audio player, with Jet Elements pretty recently, so if you already have Jet Elements, consider updating it to the latest version so you have an option to create an audio player. As you see, you can make a variety of designs with this new widget. So you can add a background image, you can add gradients to your background, you can make a different borders, different border radius, applying different border radius, and you can also make it really minimalistic. Alright, so now let's jump right in the Elementor editor, and this is the one that I have pre-designed before, and now I'm going to delete it. And we're going to recreate the same design right now so you can see how this new widget works. So now we go to Elements panel and I'll search for audio player. This is how this widget is going to look. You drop it onto a new section. So once you have added this widget to your page, you have to make a choice whether you want to pull out the file from the media library on your WordPress website, or you want to pull it out from the external link. So it is pretty simple. You grab the link anywhere you get your music and you put it in here. And then it works just the same way as with the self-hosted file. And I'll show you how to do it with the self-hosted file. So here you have this box and you have to click on it, and it takes you to the media library where you can choose the file that you want to be played in your audio player. So here, grab it and you press insert media. And there you have some generic design. So now let's have a look at the options that are available for you. So there are some settings such as audio options. You can set this track to loop, or you can set it to be muted. You know, once the user clicks on it, it's going to be muted, and then the user can just choose what volume they want the track to play at. Also in here have the control options. So you can disable some of the elements in there, such as the progress bar, the start time, the duration time, the volume bar. All right, let's have a look at all of those. So the progress bar. Once you disable it, you don't have the progress bar anymore, then the current time, duration time, volume, and you can keep on going until you have just the play button. Also, you can choose what type of the volume bar layout you want to have, either horizontal or vertical. And you can set the start volume. So here you see a little note that the start volume is the volume that this player will start playing the track. Okay, now the great news is that you also have an option to style this audio player just the way you like. So first, let's have a look at how you can change the background of this player. So what you need to do is to go to the advanced tab of this particular widget and go to the background. And here you have the option to choose the color, or you can also set it as the gradient color. So like that, and you pick the gradient location, the angle, you know, like you usually do with the gradients. And there's also an option to set an image as the background. As for the color, let's set this one. Also, if you want to have rounded borders, you go to the border radius and set it to 50. Then let's style some of the elements of the player. So what you can do here is you can set the width of the player. So if you don't want it to be full width, it doesn't have to be. Here you can center it or align it to the right or to the left. And here we go, the settings for the play and pause button. So here set the size of the icon right here on the button, the color and the background color on normal and on hover, like so. And you can also set the body radius, let it be 50, so we have the fully round button. You can also add the border if you wish, and here go the typography and the style settings for the text. In our case, this is the time, these digits representing the time. And there goes progress. You can choose the height of the progress bar. Here it goes. And the settings for the volume. There's also the icon and the progress bar. Change the font size or change the color. So here it goes. Don't forget to go to the description under this video to check out Jet Elements plugin. And also for this tutorial, I used Monster Editor WordPress theme. If you want to learn more about this theme and what's special about it and why it is so great, I totally recommend you going to the description of this video and checking the link to Monster Editor WordPress theme. So if you want to see more tutorials on Jet Elements and Elementor and Monster Editor, check out our YouTube channel. And I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you another time.